Hi, this is Marcus. I want to do a very quick tutorial on showing you how to use external photo editing applications with Capture One. Now, officially, Capture One doesn't support these applications, but it does give you the ability to utilize them. So, for instance, if we go into our application and we look at our plugins, if you go to Open with Plugin with Menus, it'll list all of the applications that are allowed to be used with Capture One. And I'm going to show you how to use it with Nik Collections. So there's a lot of different applications that it will work with. But again, if you're having an issue with it, you don't contact Capture One. You would actually have to contact the vendor. And if the vendor doesn't specifically state that they support Capture One, you might not get any support. But there's really no need for that because I have not ran into any issues when doing this. So let me just show you how it actually works. So just say, for instance, you finished this photo. This is a finished photo because you can see that it's a TIFF file. It's not a RAW file. So let's say, for instance, we finished it and the customer says, you know what? I really want to see it in black and white. Now, of course, you can recreate it or you could actually right click and create a new clone variant and make a black and white photo right inside of Capture One. Capture One has beautiful black and white tools. But if you wanted to use something like SilverFX, you could just right click and say, I want to edit with, right? And if I edit with, I can go down and I can select SilverFX. It'll come back and say, what do you want to use for SilverFX? You can do it in 16-bit or you can do it in 8-bit. Some of you want to do it in JPEG. I'm going to go ahead and do this as a TIFF. I'm not going to use Adobe RGB. I'm going to change my ICC profile to sRGB. And if I go ahead and say edit this variant, what will happen is it will create a second TIFF inside of this library. You'll see it right here. It'll have the name plus one. And it'll open this up right inside SilverFX without any issue. And the file that I'm working on, when I save it, it's going to save it right back to this TIFF file located right here inside of Capture One. So just to speed up this, I've created my own recipes inside of here. So let's just go ahead and choose one. If I said I want to do this kind of Vogue fashion, it'll give me that. And you can tweak it, of course, but I just want to show you how to actually use it. So if I wanted this type of Vogue look, I would actually hit save. And then when I hit save, that application will close. And if we go into this, now you see that we have the Nik Collection file right here that was done here. And we can go in and we can export this off. You can do this with any of the Nik Collection applications that they have in there. Let's go ahead and choose another file that is a TIFF. Let's choose another application from Nik Collections. Let's go into Analog Effects Pro. We'll say go ahead and create that. We want it to be 16-bit. Of course, I'm going to change it to color space to sRGB. We go ahead and create a new variant or edit a variant. And what it's going to do is create a new TIFF file. You'll see it create right up under the file right here. You'll see it, here it is here. It's going to go ahead and open up Analog Effects Pro. So let's choose one of the customs that comes with this application. Let's say, for instance, we wanted to get this look here from Custom 3. We go ahead and select that. There we go. We got this Analog Effects with dirt and scratches and a whole bunch of other things in there. And again, we would just go ahead and hit save. And it would write it back to the application. And when I click on that file from the application, there we go, we have it. And you can pretty much do it with any application that would allow you to add the application to this plugin that's built into Capture One. And again, the plugin is called Open with Menu. Any application that you see that it allows you to be able to select you should be able to use with no problems. So I just wanted to share that with you. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do me a favor and subscribe. I'm going to bring you more tutorials to improve your digital darkroom skills. Thank you. And I'll see you soon.